Good afternoon. I am Julie Youngquist, and this is A. Allen, and you are on Streetwise Live for the next 25 minutes on CanTV 21. We're also streaming live on cantv.org/hotline. You can also join the conversation by calling 312-738-1600. Today, like always, we'll be talking about Streetwise and the benefits of being a Streetwise vendor and purchasing, as for our customers, purchasing the Streetwise magazine. Streetwise is giving Chicagoans in need a hand up to make the changes they want to make in their lives. Allen, should we watch this video to see why people may be becoming part of Streetwise?
That's a great idea. Thank you.
Oh, how about I put it on web?
This is redemption. When do I bother at all? Nothing mentioned, and nothing has changed. So I'd rather be working for something than praying for the rain. So I wander on to someone else's shame. I move to the cold under a mountain. Swam in the ocean, slept on my own. And I told I would watch the sun cut ribbons through the bay. I remember all the things my mother wrote. We don't eat until your father's at the table. We don't drink until the devil's turned to dust. Never once has any man I've met been able to love. So if I were you, I'd have all this old trust. 'Cause we don't eat until your father's at the table. We don't drink until the devil's turned to dust. Never once has any man I've met been able to love. So if I were you, I'd have a little trouble.
Gets you every time.
Every time. It's a wonderful video. I like the song, too.
I know, me too. So, for 25 years, Streetwise has been a resource for people who need to earn an immediate income and a hand up to change their lives. Streetwise publishes a weekly magazine focused on social issues and solutions, culture, and, of course, ensuring vendor voice in each issue. This week's issue is our look back at 2017, and we'll show you the cover. The behind the scenes of Streetwise for 25 years. It was a great year as we celebrated our 25th anniversary. And over the past 25 years, more than 12,000 Chicagoans have gotten a hand up through the sale of Streetwise magazine. In a little bit, Alan is going to invite one of our special guests, Streetwise vendor Lewis Hale. He has been a vendor with us for almost 10 years and was the 2016 favorite vendor of the year. So we're going to look forward to that conversation. But before we do that, we're going to take a look at some of the numbers from 2017. All right, Alan?
Okay.
All right. Oops. Show the audience what we're looking at.
Okay.
So in 2017, we had more than 297 vendors sell about 250,000 magazines.
Wow.
Do you remember how that compares to the first issue of Streetwise magazine ever came out? How many were sold?
The first issue, it was...
It's a quiz.
The first issue was, what is it, 350,000?
350 vendors sold 60,000 issues 60, of Streetwise 000. Magazine in 5 weeks.
Okay.
And then you can see some of the ages. Most of our vendors are between 45 and 54 and male. But we have plenty of more than capable female vendors on the force. We also have our Streetwise Transitional Jobs Program that helps return people back to the kind of wage market, earning a paycheck, which is not your favorite way.
Right, I love
cash man.
I like that cold, cold cash. I love that cold, cold cash.
So the Streetwise Transitional Jobs Program last year served 74 people. Again, most people between the ages of 45 and 54. And you can see we serve a pretty healthy mix of men and women, although we skew a little bit heavier towards the male side. Then overall in the organization, I don't know if we're going to be able to see this very well. Let's see. Oh, close enough. About 54% of our Streetwise participants last year across all of our programs. That's through the food program, the STEP program, the magazine vendor program, identified some sort of disability. About 7% of our participants are veterans, and 40% of our participants do have housing, which is great news, and more are getting housing. And then just over 60 people a day come in to have a meal, use the computers, use the phone, get housing resources, talk with one of the employees about any needs that they have for their well-being. So Alan wanted to share, did you want to still do the look back at 25 years?
Yeah, that's a great idea.
Okay, you want to go to that page?
Okay, 25
Here,
years?
This one.
Oh, okay.
Are you going to read that?
Yeah, I'd like to share this with you.
All right.
Our very own Judy Youngquist wrote, it's hard to believe that 25 years ago, on August the 24th in 1992, the first edition of Streetwise hit the streets of Chicago. Our founder, Judd Lofty, found a practical solution to the crisis of homelessness in Chicago. The idea was simple: give homeless men and women a chance to gain economical self-sufficiency, personal dignity, and help themselves by selling a newspaper to earn an income rather than beg. More than 350 homeless men and women purchased and sold more than 60,000 issues of Streetwise within the first 5 weeks. The first 5 weeks, hey. Over the past 25 years, more than 12,000 men and women have taken a hand up and not a handout. Collectively, they have sold more than 19 million copies of Streetwise. Selling Streetwise is a job. Our vendors are self-employed entrepreneurs. Our success is due to the commitment, dedication, and persistence of our Streetwise magazine vendors. They go out each day to greet you, their loyal customers. It is because of your support that vendors can pay rent, utilities, purchase food, clothing, and even have some money. We have had great time celebrating the founding and growth of Streetwise in the past 25 years. We've hosted a VIP reception with our 25 most significant people in the history of Streetwise. Honorees who are vital to the growth, sustainability, and the future of Streetwise. Our vendors had a party at Streetwise headquarters, and some of us
hit the streets to celebrate the birthday by selling magazines and raising awareness on August the 24th. All of this capped off with our annual gala on August 28th as we celebrate more than 425 guests, raising over $200,000. See the pictures and images below over our last 25 years and anniversary celebration. The celebration has been a reminder of the community support that has kept us going for 25 years. Get the magazine and read all about it this week. Behind the scenes, Streetwise.
That's right. So, are you ready to move into the host seat and interview our good friend Lewis?
Yes, I will.
All right. Well, first of all, we have this great video of Lewis from WCIU a couple of years ago. So while he gets comfortable, we're going to show this to you.
The Streetwise organization has offered homeless men and women the opportunity to buy and sell magazines as a way to make money and to get off the streets.
And if you ask around, most people know at least one or two Streetwise vendors. Right across from our studios, Lewis Hale has been hard at work selling magazines for years. This year, he hopes to win the favorite vendor competition. Take a look.
I've been working with Streetwise for 9 years, and it has been one experience. It's not just a job, it's an adventure. You have your good and bad days, but I like the challenge. And I know a lot of people. I can't walk anywhere in Chicago without being known. So I know a lot of dogs because I keep treats for the dogs. 9 years ago, I was homeless, living on the street, and I just saw it as an opportunity to make money and get out of my situation. And within 4 months, I was out of my situation. I haven't been on the street since. And my life has really changed, selling Streetwise through just being consistent every day and being there, and there's a lot of good people out. I really thank God to be able to sell Streetwise. I don't want to put myself above everybody. I think everybody deserves to win. I've been doing this a long time, but one of the things that motivates me, I mean, I want to win because it's cash, and I also want to propose to my girlfriend at the gala, so that's a big factor. I never would be able to afford a big gala like that, get married, but yeah, if I win, I will propose to her at the gala.
That's awesome.
So sweet.
Although he just ruined the surprise.
That's what I said.
Yeah.
I know. Although maybe it's not a surprise.
Yeah. Reminder, you are watching Streetwise Live on CAN TV 21. At this point, I'd like to welcome Lewis to CAN TV. Welcome, Lewis.
Well, thanks for having me, and thanks everyone for watching and spending your time to see the show.
Well, not only has Lewis been the vendor of the year for 2016, but he's also our vendor for the month, this month. We have calendars. We have calendars. If you don't have a Streetwise calendar, ask your local vendor about a Streetwise calendar. Lewis is the man for the month, for the month of March. And Lewis, before we get started, I'd like to know, how did you become involved with Streetwise?
Well, I got involved with Streetwise as a result of my bad choices. I was living on the street, and I would see guys selling Streetwise, and I just thought that that was a way that I could really do good at that.
That's kind of peculiar, because I came to Streetwise on the same basis because of bad choices. And I think it's a lot of our vendor story, because we have made bad decisions, but Streetwise seemed to be the proper decision for us, you know, that have experienced bad choices, okay, over and over and over again. You know, for me, Streetwise was a good choice because it put the responsibility on me. And that's what gave me the understanding of what a hand up and not a handout is, okay? It's not feeling sorry for a person, but it's actually helping a person to do the best that they can do, right?
That's right.
Okay. I have one more question to ask you. How long have you been selling Streetwise?
I've been selling Streetwise in May of this year will be 11 years.
Wow.
11 years. And I've been at my current location, 1525 North Clark, for 10 years now.
Wow. Wow, that is something. Okay, tell me this. What are some of the stereotypes and misconceptions about Streetwise vendors, in your opinion?
You could write a big, long book about that one.
Okay.
But some of the main ones is that you're homeless, that you come from the projects, that you're dumb, you name it.
Those are some misconceptions that I noticed. And I know that you had wrote in one of your articles or one of your profiles that people would often come up to you and give you their leftover food, you know, as if you're really hungry and desperate. And, you know, that's sort of offensive, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, especially after you've taken a bite off of it. Because I didn't even want it, you know, everybody is a little different. You know, you got rich people that'll eat like that, but I just don't get down like that.
That's good. That's good. And tell me this, how have Streetwise helped you?
Streetwise has helped me in a lot of ways, but mainly by giving me the opportunity to buy the magazine and sell and give me the badge. That was really all I needed, was just the opportunity to make money. Some of the services help people get housing. I wasn't really able to get help with that because of different barriers, but through me selling and being out on the street and networking and meeting people, they were able to help me get apartments. 'Cause we have some barriers of people trying to get into housing even though they have the money.
Okay.
It's not always about the money. There's credit checks and different backgrounds and this and that. And it takes more than, it takes you being out there and meeting people. And I happen to be in a very good neighborhood with people that are well off and they have power. And so they were able to help me to get several places. Over the last 10 years, I've had 2 different apartments. And not through my own doing, because I had the money, but through them and their word, I was able to get a place to stay, you know.
Okay. And I think that's like part of the motto of a hand up and not a handout. When people see you actually out there being responsible at your location, people are willing to help people that's willing to help themselves. You know, we are consider ourselves as entrepreneurs, okay? We are self-employed, okay? Through our own efforts. That means that we have to be there. We work this like it's a job, right?
Oh yeah, it's definitely a business and job for me.
Yeah, and we consider ourselves entrepreneur, and I'm glad you're here to verify that. Okay, what have you learned from working with Streetwise that have helped you in other areas in your life, Lewis?
I have learned to not judge a book by its cover.
Oh, okay.
'Cause the person that you think doesn't have anything may be your best customer. So I try to treat everyone with kindness. Lately, I've been dealing with being on the alert because there's been a lot of crime in my area.
Okay.
People busting in cars and stuff. So I don't want to be too nice out there.
Okay.
But, you know, basically just, you know, kindness can go a long way.
Yes, it can.
Yeah.
And that's part of our Streetwise code of conduct. We believe in being kind, respectful, you know, to people, even if they say no to the magazine. And then a lot of times when you mention judging a book by its cover, okay, we don't want people to judge us by, you know, he's a Streetwise vendor and he's homeless. You know, these are some of the stereotypes that people get when they see a Streetwise vendor. So we really don't want people to prejudge us and stereotype us and read us like a book just by the cover. By us being out there selling, we are actually trying to help ourselves, okay? Mm-hmm. We are actually trying. Okay, for me, when I came to Streetwise, I was like in a terrible situation because my record was so bad, right? Would nobody hire me? Even if they did hire me, by the time my record came back, as far as my criminal record, people would be like, I have to let you go. I'm sorry, your criminal record is bad. Which, actually, I didn't have any offensive crimes to a person, you know, personal person, you know, as far as putting my hands on anybody. All my violations was, like, basically drugs, okay, and doing things under the influence of drugs. So I hate that people are misconceived that, you know, because of if I say I was fired because of my criminal background, people would take that in the wrong way and say, oh, he must be violent. When actually, I'm not a violent person, you know. But to avoid going through the changes with different jobs, I came to Streetwise. And Streetwise, like yourself, it offered me an opportunity to be able to present myself as a person, okay? And people accepted me, and they didn't judge me, and they bought magazines from me, and they kind of helped me because I was helping myself, okay? What have helped you to be successful with Streetwise, Mr. Lewis?
Well, putting in a lot of time and not forcing myself on people and kind of earning the trust from people by being there every day and kind. And I have a special relationship with dogs. Oh, I really love dogs. Mm-hmm. So by trial and error, I discovered, well, I mean, everybody knows that dogs run up to you when you got treats for them. So kind of through a little trial and error, I discovered that it's a good thing to give dogs treats. So I have another little business through trial and error of watching people's dogs when they go in the store, and have developed a relationship with people's dogs, learning people's names and things about them. And over the years, developing relationships, and I have a business today. So basically that, and like I say, not forcing myself on people, because nobody owes me a thing. The sooner that the person that doesn't want a magazine walks on, the quicker the guy comes that wants something.
Right.
So I kind of look at it as the law of averages.
Right.
I've learned the law of averages. If you keep asking for something but not too pushy, you're going to eventually get it.
And that's a positive attitude, and that's what I like. And then when you mention the dog, you know, and as being an entrepreneur, as being a professional, you know, that means that when you see a person coming down the street with a dog, not only are you kind to that person, but you're kind to the dog. And I have experimented with that too. You know, I have gave the dog some treats, and you know, eventually that dog will recognize you, and he will actually pull that person to you, you know, by the leash. And that person, once they get to you, then what they gonna do? They're going to take the dog treat and eventually buy a paper, you know. So kindness, like you say, does go a long ways, you know, especially with Streetwise. And, you know, you mentioned as your business as an entrepreneur. But you, not only that, but you're a very popular guy with Streetwise. You know, you're a very popular guy with your customers. That's why you was voted Vendor of the Year. Okay, at the Vendor of the Year gala, what was it like? You was on the cover of Streetwise magazine, and you're the Vendor of the Year. So what happened at the gala? Would you like to share it?
Well, I got an award, and I was able to stand in front of people and speak. And then I proposed to my fiance.
That's the part I'm talking about.
Yeah.
That's a wonderful thing. I was there. As a matter of fact, we sat at the same table. And you proposed to her, and what happened?
She said yes. And I have a picture of us here.
Okay.
We're getting married in August. I really look forward to that. And here is a picture of us right here.
Oh, ain't that nice?
In August.
That's so beautiful.
Of last year at the event that we'll be getting married at.
Okay.
So I'm right now just working on that, family.
And so, you know, not only is that valuable to me because I was there and you're a friend of mine, you know, but Streetwise is like a family affair, you know. A family affair, not only with your customers, but with each other. And to see that happen at the gala, that made me feel like I was getting engaged. I know I'm not getting engaged, but it made me feel like, you know, family members getting engaged, so I'm a part of it, right? So, you know, this is what I like about Streetwise, the camaraderie and the family environment that we have when you come to the office. Okay, you can get a meal. You know, you can join different programs. We have a job program. You can join different jobs programs, you know. And it's just a lot of things we can do. We do have parties. We had the parties to celebrate the 25th anniversary. And we've been having parties since. We've been having a lot of celebrations. So I would like to thank Lewis for being here. And not only that, but I would like to invite anyone else that's out there and you're looking for employment. You know, you want to be self-employed, maybe this is for you. You can come in. You know, you can come to orientation. Our orientation is Tuesday and Thursday at 10 o'clock. You can come in, we'll get you started.